Getting to this point hasn't exactly been easy. Leaving a wife and two young children at home is hard enough without having a grandfather terminally ill. And the thought of the possible chance of not being able to share the story with him upon my return. Waking up to that email from WTA Tags is one I certainly won't forget. To find out I beat the odds and drew a New Mexico elk tag in the Gila. To put it in perspective, kind of like winning lotto for any hunter. New Mexico is a completely random draw, simply like drawing a ticket out of the hat and having your name on it. With my first year of applying, never did I think 2016 was to be my year. Since drawing the tag, all my time has been consumed by this hunt. The anticipation is something I can't explain.
Well, here we are in New Mexico in the Gila wilderness. Just at the moment, we're sitting here trying to locate some elk. Yesterday was a big day, but didn't see too much. It was a bit quiet, but we are pretty early in the season too. So one of the other guys has been spotting and he heard some in here yesterday. So, but we'll keep pushing on. Still got plenty of days left. Yeah, it's kind of a dream come true. So yeah, I'm sure we'll make the most of it.
Early season, being the first 2 weeks of September, was proving very different to the late September hunts in Montana that I experienced in previous years. High temperatures and little to no bugling made us continually search new country, trying to locate and intercept silent bulls before they'd bed throughout the heat of the day. With Matt's experience in the early season, several evenings had us building a blind on waterholes with fresh elk activity. Trying to use the lack of wind and dry conditions to our advantage made sense. got enough sign here, both new and old, to reassure us that we're in the right area, and knowing that each day is only likely to get better as the rut approaches. Thank you.
Yeah, we've got a late start this morning. We headed into town yesterday. The boys are quite crook, so we had to go to the hospital, get checked out. They're fixed up now, but big storm front come through late yesterday afternoon and flooded us out, so we couldn't actually get up here till this morning. I think about 8:30, I think we ended up heading out of camp for a hunt. So today we've just sort of been covering a bit of country, having a look around, and for the last couple of hours we've been sitting off this mineral lick. The soil actually sparkles in the sunlight. It's got a big pad of it, and there's an old tree stand above it, so it's obviously got a little bit of history. So we'll see what this afternoon brings. We've heard a couple of bugles way back, so we'll sit here and we'll make our way up the hill shortly and see if we can intercept them coming down out of their beds.
As planned, Matt was to leave us on day 6 of our 14-day hunt and left base camp for us to continue to use and hunt at our own accord. It was now that experience of several successful elk hunts between us and the years of hunting red deer back home in Australia would be relied upon. The days were fast approaching to an end, with the previous day no different to the next. We knew we were drawing closer to peak rut. Seeing and having more encounters with bulls, just none I was willing to end this hunt on. Nothing was more mature than I had taken on previous hunts. With so many days already invested, and limited days left, no other hunting pressure, bulls were bugling more regular, we'd be crazy to change things now. It felt like something was building for us, and the bull I was looking for would soon show, and hopefully give me that chance.
Ooh.
not glad this hunt is over. I'm grateful to be able to take the animal and somewhat relieved that all the planning, commitment and effort has been rewarded, not just by me, but everyone involved. So much to take out of the past 13 days, the highs and lows, not just the physical gain but the mental one. But as I walk off this mountain for the last time, I can't help but wonder when I'll get to experience another day like today. The sights, the sounds, and everything that elk hunting has to offer. Will it be next year? Will I ever draw the tag again? One thing's for sure, I'll be doing everything I can to return to the Gila. Thank you.